Hello, everyone. Happy Saturday. Hey, guys.
Hi, it's Jennifer. Hey, how is everyone? I was getting ready to come on Periscope a few minutes ago, and I'm like, oh man, Alex Pettit's already live. And then I was getting ready to come on, and then Chip Gaines was live. Are you guys Fixer Upper fans from Chip and Joanna? They're amazing. So, quick little Periscope tip. You never want to scope when Chip Gaines is live. Watching you while working at the Irish Fest. Hey, how are you, Kansas City girl? And you never want to scope when Alex Pettit is on either, okay? Because you'll get no one on your scope. Just know that going into it. I think Chip and Joanna had 800 people live watching his Periscope. So anyhow, I know the Fixer Upper people are amazing. Real quick, let me introduce myself and then I'll tell you a little bit about the Fixer Upper people. My name is Jennifer Alwyn. I own the Magic Brush. It's a decorative painting company in Kansas City, Missouri. So we go into people's houses. We make their houses beautiful by painting their walls, painting their cabinets. Hey, thank you. I appreciate that. I'm showing a little more there than I'd prefer. There we go. And so we have a fantastic job. We get to have so much fun decorating houses. We've done 3 homes for Extreme Home Makeover, been published in many magazines locally and nationally. I'm writing my first book. You can't see or hear anything. Try going out, Joanne, and coming back in, because my guess is it's on your end. Yes, Chip always does have a large scope. So last year, I went with 2 of my friends, 2 local Kansas City girls, the owner of Restoration Emporium and the owner of The Chabbiest Chic, which I am trying to get her to get on Periscope. My new book about, it's a lot of DIY stuff. And some surprises. Let me just say that. It'll be out next week. I know your first day on Periscope. I've been on Periscope for a month. And the first week, I was like a crack addict. Like, I just kept scoping and watching. And then after like 10 days, I joined. And then I was trying to decide for my world, for DIYers, creative entrepreneurs, because I coach creative entrepreneurs on how to build their business. Oh, good. I'm glad you can see me now. You would not want to miss all this big hair. Good grief. It's big. I washed it this morning, so it's bigger than normal. But so I coach creative entrepreneurs. And so I just wrote last week because I have a really great social media following, mostly on Facebook. I have 121,000 people following me there. So if you are not following me on Facebook, go and find Jennifer Alwyn, public figure, not my personal one, and follow me there. So what I was wanting to do is try this social media for my industry, for other creative entrepreneurs, for other crafters, DIYers. If you know people like that, please share the scope. I know my hair is Texas big, but I live in Kansas City, and it's just kind of this big naturally. It'll be calmed down tomorrow, Kat, I promise. And by the way, I love your name and want it. Okay, so anyhow, last year I spoke at the home show, or went down to Waco with my 2 friends, and we met Chip and Joe, and they are as amazing in person as they are on their television show. I would just like to say that. And you found me on Pinterest yesterday. Mwah! Thank you. I love Pinterest. I'm addicted. And I teach creative people how to use Pinterest for their business. Shh. Okay. So, and then last year, Chip and Joanna came to Kansas City and spoke at the Kansas City Home and Garden Show, where I spoke as well. So Chip and Joe spoke. I spoke. Chip and Joe spoke. I was like a Chip and Joe sandwich. It was hilarious. So anyway, okay, here's what I'm scoping about. You started Periscope because of my Facebook. Yay. All right. This is what I want to show you. If you follow my Facebook page for Jennifer Alwyn, this public person or whatever it is, you'll know that yesterday I just got a wild hair and decided I wanted to get the fabric and make curtains for my office. Okay. And so I got them up last night before I went to bed. Now, here you go. I want to flip this around and I'll start showing you how. This is my office. Welcome to my home. And let me see if I can get you here where the lighting is better. Okay. I am obsessed with that fabric. Please tell me by show of hearts, shares, something that you two are obsessed with this. Okay, right? I am obsessed with it. So this is my office where I work, and I am here because I coach entrepreneurs and I'm on social media all the time. I'm here for 6 to 7 hours a day in my home office. And frankly, I was pretty irritated with myself that I didn't have any curtains up. I've lived here 12 years. And so no, I did not sew it. I don't own a sewing machine. And that's what I want to share with you guys. I'm so stinking excited. I'm feeling a little bit like a genius. Okay, first of all,
Big shout out to Hobby Lobby. This is a fabric they are carrying that's called Santa Maria. I have been looking at pre-made curtains on Etsy in this fabric, but it was a little pricey. I'm just going to be honest with you. And I wanted four really long panels. And, you know, so I wasn't just ordering a set of two, I was ordering a set of four. And I still have to do the bottoms, but I'm going to show you that. Okay, so following a friend of mine on Facebook at Vintage Charm Restored, she put us a picture of this and said, hey, they've got this fabric at Hobby Lobby. I'm going to flip the camera here real quick. And so I'm like, what? I could go get it. Oh, yeah, but I don't sew. But there's always workarounds. How many of you know that there's always workarounds? And ask me that fireplace question in just a second. So I'm going to show you guys what I used. Hang on. I'm walking. Okay, so I'm in Hobby Lobby, and I'm talking to the lovely lady, Colleen, who was cutting my fabric. She was lovely, and I just thought she was adorable. And I told her, Colleen, I don't sew. And as many of you know, if you follow my Facebook page or you get my emails from themagicbrushink.com, I am all about like DIY hacks and doing things faster. If you do everything, okay, let me just take me as an example. If I measure things out and perfectly cut everything and iron it and stitch it on a machine and measure and hang, literally, like, I would just rather shoot myself in the foot. I do not have any time for any of that nonsense. I swear to you, as surely as I'm standing here, when I decide I want something, I want it yesterday. And that means when I decide I want to do a project, I don't want it to stretch out for 2 weeks. I mean, for the love, come on. I got other crap I need to decorate. I got stuff that needs glittered. I got pumpkins that need painted. I got, you know, other projects even half done around my house at any given time. And so when I decide I want to do something, I want to know the quickest way to get from A to B. Now, that doesn't mean that I'm cutting all sorts of corners and things aren't going to look gorgeous. It just means a girl's got to know like where she wants to spend her time. And I don't want to spend my time sewing. I love you sewers. If my mama's on here, my mom's a sewer and she's great at it. I did not get the sewing gene. I got the big hair gene. I got the bright lipstick gene, the faux painting gene, and the decorating gene. But I did not get the sewing one. So here's what I used. Ready? Are you ready? Okay, here goes. Hang on. I'm going to show you because I think I have to turn this around. You love my shirt. Thank you. You're sweet. All right, come on, camera. All right, here we go. This, let me turn to where the lighting's better, is what I used. Peel and stick fabric fuse from Hobby Lobby. Oh my gosh, you guys, it comes in a roll. And I just want to tell you, take a screenshot of this real quick, first of all, okay? I'm going to give you a couple more seconds here. Tell me if you guys have used this in your comments, would you? And if you know any other fellow non-sewers and would like to, write, game changer, Lisa Taylor, game changer. Share this scope. I would be so honored. So here's what you do. I'm going to show you on my curtains. I'm like showing you all my dirty little secrets here. I did not make sure the line was straight. I borrowed scissors from my neighbor because all of my scissors have paint on them or like dried glue from my 7-year-old daughter or whatever else. Vicky wants to know if that tape's expensive. $3.29, I think, was the price at Hobby Lobby. Now, it took me one roll because each roll, let me see, each roll goes 20 feet and my panels are 8.5 feet long. And the reason I didn't go with the iron-on one is because then I got to iron, girls. I mean, if I can just press with my fingers, who wants to iron when you can just press? And so anyway, thank you for inviting followers. You are my favorite. I don't see who did that, but thank you for that. And so I'm going to flip this around again, and I'm going to see if I can get you a really good shot of my hem. And by hem, I mean pressed on. All right, let's see. The lighting isn't fantastic there. I think it's better here. Okay, so I laid this fabric down last night on my kitchen floor. This is apparently got an official word for it. This thing that goes up on the side. Who can tell me what that official word is? It was something like selvage or something. A couple people on my Facebook page were telling me. I don't know. I know not fancy words. Selvage, okay? S-E-L-V-A-G-E. Junk art, is it selvage? Is that right? Okay, so I literally just rolled it over and put that sticky tape in between there. I promise you guys, it took me, I would say, 30 minutes to do each panel. And then we used clips at the top. Can you see the clips? So they do have a little hem there. I did run out of tape last night and had no energy. I knew that Hobby Lobby was going to be closed, and I don't really want to go to Walmart at 11 o'clock at night. So I didn't get the bottoms done. I do have to hem them. I am going to let them pool just a little bit. But I'm telling you girls, for those of you who are into decorating but are not into it taking 5 million hours, you know, and you have a lot of things you want to get done, follow my Facebook page, first of all. Go find Jennifer Allwood there. Second of all, stay tuned because I'll give you some more hacks. I do stuff like this all the time. Yes, Mr. Magic hung these for me last night. And you know what I'm going to scope about tomorrow? I'm going to tell you what I'm going to scope about. I was trying to decide if I wanted to scope about it today. Here, where's the lighting decent? Or if I was going to wait and scope about it tomorrow. I'm going to do it tomorrow. I'm going to scope about how I get Mr. Magic to help me with so many projects. It's not by begging. It's not by nagging. It is not by manipulation. But my husband has always been a trooper with projects, and I do think that I have some wise biblical tips on how to get our spouses to help us. And if we don't have a spouse that's willing to help us on projects, you got girlfriends, right? You got a sister, you got a neighbor. I mean, nagging about it and hoping food, right? Well, my husband does all the cooking. Don't hate me, but I can't cook or sew. And so he does all the cooking. But it basically comes down to respect. And it basically comes down to affirming them in public, in front of your girlfriends, in front of your family. He does have a servant heart. But making them feel so appreciated. And so I'm going to talk about that tomorrow, okay? Going to say, because we're all thinking. Well, if that's their love language, I mean, let's be honest, girls, let's just put it out there. And so you got to know your spouse's love language. In my case, my spouse's love language is words of affirmation. And if you don't know anything about love languages, get the book by Gary Chapman. Okay, I'm going to tell you real quick. The 5 love languages are, then you girls tell me which of yours, all right? You can build a home out of a house, so that's a God-given talent, right? The 5 love languages. Words of affirmation, which is my personal one. Gifts, which 2 of my kids are gifts, and I thought that they were greedy. It's that their love language is gifts. That's how they feel the most loved. Physical affection is a 3rd love language. 4th is acts of service, which is pretty low on my meter. Physical affection and time. Is that right? Words of affirmation. Okay, so words of affirmation, physical touch, time, gifts, acts of service. Those are the 5 love languages. So you got to know what your spouse's love language is. You've got to ask them in the right way. And I'm not talking manipulation. This is not manipulation. But there are some ways that you can get your husband or your wife or whoever, I guess those would be the only 2 options, to help you on projects. So I'm going to talk to you guys about that tomorrow. Hopefully the lighting will be a little better than all this weird stuff across my face. Okay, so anyway, we'll scope again tomorrow. Bless you all. If this was fun and you think you have anybody in your world that would enjoy knowing how to sew with adhesive tape, share this one for me, would you? Okay, bless you guys. Oh, it's called The 5 Love Languages, and it's by Gary Chapman. And once you know, thank you, Midwest DIY. Now, you're my favorite. Once you know your own love language, you understand why you respond to people in a certain way. My personal love language is words of affirmation. So when people tell me they appreciate me, or I get a card, or somebody writes me a letter, that does more for my heart than if they wash my car. Does that make sense? One of my closest girlfriends, her love language is time. She needs me to spend physical time with her. Now, another one of my friends, her love language is not time at all. So we can pick up the phone and talk to each other, and it's been 2 weeks, and we just pick back up where we left off. Does that make sense? Hey, thanks. I appreciate you too. So once you know your own love language, and once you know the people in your world, especially the people who live under the same roof, or if you're like me and you have employees and you have contractors working for you, I employ at the Magic Brush on any given day. I've had up to 8 girls painting for me at any given time. Some of those girls are going to do best if I write them a card and say, you know what, you stinking rock. You're so talented. I'm so glad you work for me. Other girls on my team are going to do better if I give them a $50 gift card to Target and I say, I appreciate you. The other girls just want me to hang out and assist them for a little while. Does that make sense? So once you know how people most feel loved, you can love them in the way that makes them feel so good that then they want to love you back.
and they want to love you the way that you best fill up. So I hope that makes sense. I do have the heart of a teacher. Thank you. And I did not realize this about myself until 2 years ago, how much I love to teach, not just on painting and crafting and DIYing, but just on heart stuff and women's stuff and love stuff. So anyway, bless you all. I think you're amazing. And I'm going to run and I'll be back scoping tomorrow. Okay. And just know that my hair probably will look much different tomorrow. It's probably going to be in a bun up on the top of my head. Oh, I'm also going to scope tomorrow from my best friend's house because, hey, thank you. God is using me in some great ways. And thank you. I received that in the name of Jesus. Thank you. And so I'm going to my best friend's house tomorrow. We're having a painting party because friends help friends paint. Did you know that? Especially if your friend's love language is acts of service. Mm-hmm. All right. So I'll catch you girls tomorrow. Okay. All right. Bye-bye. I always have trouble stopping these things. Always.